Hi, I'm George Perry, Beef Reproduction Specialist for South Dakota State University.
And I'm Warren Rusche, SDSU Extension Cow-Calf Field Specialist.
For successful insemination of cattle to occur, animals must be detected in standing estrus. Standing estrus is the result of a series of hormonal changes that occur at the end of each estrus cycle. Detecting standing estrus, also referred to as heat detection or detecting standing heat, is simply looking for the changes in animal behavior associated with cows or heifers standing to be mounted by a bull or another cow or heifer. With natural service, estrus detection is considered to be easy. It's the bull's job. However, for successful artificial insemination of cattle to occur, the producer must take the place of the herd bull in detecting which cows or heifers are ready to be inseminated. Therefore, accurate detection of animals in standing estrus plays a vital role in the success of any artificial insemination program. We can see here how when conception rates are held constant, changes in estrus detection rate have a big impact on pregnancy success. With a 95% estrus detection rate and a 70% conception rate, 67% of the animals will be pregnant, whereas only a 39% pregnancy rate will occur with a 55% estrus detection rate. Accurate estrus detection can be a difficult and time-consuming activity. Therefore, knowing and understanding the changes in animal behavior is critical for success.
The only true sign of standing estrus is when a cow or heifer stands to be mounted by a bull or another female. We can see here when a heifer is in standing estrus, she will lock up and not move when mounted by another heifer. Because it's difficult, though, to monitor animals 24 hours a day for standing estrus, it's also important to be able to observe for secondary signs of standing estrus and to know when they occur. First, we will see animals congregating or grouping together. Cattle that are in standing estrus naturally seek out other heifers in standing estrus and form a small group, referred to as the sexually active group. This group will often include animals that are in estrus and also animals that are coming into heat. This group will constantly be moving as heifers that are in estrus are persistently being followed by animals that are coming into estrus. We can see here how some heifers will persistently trail other heifers that are in estrus. Within this sexually active group, there are obvious signs that an animal is coming into estrus, but animals not involved in this group should also be observed for these signs. Animals that are in standing estrus or approaching this stage will usually try to mount other cows and heifers in the group. Remember, only the cow or heifer that stands to be mounted is actually in standing estrus. The cow that is doing the riding may be in estrus or may not be. If she mounts an animal a few times and then leaves the sexually active group, she likely isn't in standing estrus. But a cow or heifer that consistently mounts other females in that group may be coming into standing estrus and requires further observation. In addition, cows that are mounted but do not stand need to be observed further to see if they will eventually stand to be ridden and then are definitely in standing estrus. Another secondary sign of estrus is the discharge of clear mucus from the vagina of the cow or heifer. Higher levels of estrogen cause thick, clear mucus to be released from within the cow's cervix. When a cow or heifer is mounted by another animal, stands to be ridden, or when the reproductive tract is stimulated during artificial insemination, mucus may be expelled from the vulva. Strings of mucus hanging from the vulva or smeared on the tail and buttocks are a good indication that the cow or heifer is either in standing estrus or approaching that stage. Another sign is chin resting. Animals coming into estrus will often rest their chin on the hip or rump of another animal. Or they may be licking at the other animal. Bulling refers to one animal headbutting or pushing around another animal. Roughed up tail heads or hair rubbed off of the tail head is another indication of heifers or cows that are coming into estrus. As an animal is mounted, the hair on their tail head will become roughed up, and if they are mounted enough times, the hair on their tail head can become rubbed off. Also, depending on the time of the year or the weather conditions, you may see mud on an animal's side after they've been mounted. Plus, as an animal's activity level increases with estrus, their hair may become wet due to the animal sweating, especially under warmer conditions.
One thing to realize when observing for secondary signs of standing estrus is the signs are basically the same if an animal is coming into estrus or going out of estrus. Therefore, to maximize detection of standing estrus, it's extremely important to visually monitor cattle as much as possible. In addition, a common misconception is that when bloody mucus is observed, it is an indication that an animal did not conceive. This simply is not true. In cattle, observing some bloody mucus is very common 1 to 3 days after an animal was in standing estrus. Therefore, if you see this and you inseminated the cow 1 to 3 days ago, you were probably correct on your observations. But if you see a bloody discharge and you have not inseminated her, it is definitely too late to inseminate her for this estrus cycle. Continuous observation of over 500 animals exhibiting natural estrus in 3 separate studies indicated 55.9% of cows initiated standing estrus from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m. Therefore, detection of standing estrus can be one of the most time-consuming chores related to artificial insemination. However, the more frequent the observation, the greater the likelihood of detecting animals in standing estrus. The ability of the observer to recognize the secondary signs associated with standing estrus are learned through experience. A good understanding of the signs associated with standing estrus, combined with the dedication to visually observe the animals during the artificial insemination period, will greatly improve the likelihood of a successful breeding season. For more information on estrus detection and other reproductive management issues, more information can be found on the SDSU Extension website, iGrow.org.